A very good morning, dear students. I, Divya Sharma, once again welcome you all to my online class, which is undoubtedly a result of the marvelous opportunity and encouragement given by RO Jabalpur. Dear children, in our previous class, we studied that there are two types of letters, formal and informal letters, and we studied how to write leave applications to the principal. I have provided the link to my previous class in the description box below. The students who could not attend the previous class, along with those who want to view it again, can do so through that link. Now let's start with our today's session without any further delay. Our today's class is going to be very interesting as well as useful for you, because by the end of today's class, you all will be able to write wonderful letters to your near and dear ones. Exciting, right? I'm saying so because in today's class, we'll learn how to write informal letters. Informal letters are the letters that are written in a personal style. Such letters are usually addressed to family, friends, acquaintances, etc. Now, dear children, there's a new word for you, acquaintances. We know what is family and we know what are friends. But to some of us, acquaintances is a new word. Some of us are not acquainted with this word. So, to be acquainted with something means to be familiar with something. And acquaintance is a person with whom we are familiar. But he or she is not our close friend. For example, in your classroom, there are so many children studying with you. You have friends in your classroom, but what about rest of the classmates, whom you do not call your friends? They would be your classmates, and these classmates can be called your acquaintances. I hope the term is clear to you all now. In simple words, this means that formal letters are written to the family members, friends and acquaintances like colleagues, that is the people who work with us, our classmates or neighbors, etc. However, in class 6, we usually get questions in which we have to write a letter to either our friends or to family members. Family members include our grandparents, grandfather and grandmother, our uncles and aunts, and our cousins. Furthermore, a writer of the letter who is living in a hostel or boarding school may even be asked to write to his or her parents or siblings. Students, siblings means the children who have common parents, and cousins means the children of our uncles or aunts. Just like formal letters, while writing informal letters also, we need to be considerate about certain key points. The first and foremost thing is that we need to follow the word limit. In real life, we may write a long letter to our family or friends. But while writing in the class or examination, we must keep in mind the word limit. These letters have informal and personal tone. And that is why these letters are also referred to as personal letters. With respect to the language, children, please bear in mind that not only you should be respectful when you are writing to an elder, but also polite while writing to a friend. Never confuse the word informal with disrespectful. In such letters, you might use abbreviations and idioms wherever necessary. They are not compulsory to be used. If you feel that an abbreviation, that is a short form or a contraction, needs to be used somewhere in the letter, you may use it in an informal letter. Idioms, children, are phrases that we use to make our language more colorful. So in the course of the examples that we study, I'll show you how we can use idioms in case of informal letters. Like a formal letter, an informal letter should also be well structured. That is, its content should not be written in a single paragraph, but should be appropriately divided into different paragraphs. And its format should be accurate and in correct order. So let's proceed to see what the format of an informal letter is like. This, students, is the format of an informal letter. Just like a formal letter, an informal letter also begins with the sender's address. Sender, we know, is the person who writes the letter. After this comes the date of writing the letter. Then comes the salutation. And children, the salutation of an informal letter is also informal because we will of course not address our family or friends as sir or ma'am. Hence, it will be personal and depend on the receiver. Afterwards, we commence with the body or content of the letter. The content is divided into mainly three paragraphs, of which the first may contain the greetings and a brief or short description of the purpose of writing the letter. Greetings include inquiry about the health of the receiver, or you can directly start your letter also. The greeting should be positive and comforting. In the second paragraph, we further develop the purpose or the motive of writing our letter. This means that we elaborate on the purpose that we have briefly mentioned in the above paragraph. Finally, we conclude the letter in the third paragraph by summing up the reason for writing the letter and saying a meaningful and affectionate goodbye to the receiver. This may be in the form of a promise to write again, or you may ask the receiver to write back to you. Subsequently comes the complimentary closing. The complimentary closing of an informal letter should be warm and friendly. And then we have to write the name of the sender. With this, we have gone through the description of the format of an informal letter. Now let's go through some examples. Here we have our first question. It says, write a letter to your uncle thanking him for the book he sent to you as your birthday gift. So it's a very simple letter. As you can see, you have to write a letter to your uncle. This shows that it is an informal letter, because just now we studied that to our relatives we write informal letters. And what is the subject of your letter? You have to thank your uncle for sending you a book as your birthday present. So let's see the solution to this question. As per the rules of format that we have just studied, we'll start with the sender's address. Sender's address was not given in the question, so I have invented one. I have written A45 Amar Colony, Nagpur. You can write any address that you want to, because it is not given in the question to you. Then I have written the date, March 10, 2020. And because I have written the month first, then the date, I have put a comma to separate the date from the year. Then comes the salutation. I have written dearest uncle. Remember, I told you that the salutation of an informal letter should be personal. So I have written dearest uncle. You can also write dear uncle. Whatever you wish to write, you may choose. The first paragraph says, how are you all? We are fine here. I received your letter and gift parcel yesterday, which you sent for me on my birthday. I jumped for joy when I opened the parcel. So here the writer, that is the sender of the letter, Tejaswini. You can see the name that I have written in the end. Tejaswini has started the letter with a greeting. She has inquired about the well-being of her uncle and his family, and she has answered for herself that she and her parents are fine. Then she has given a little background to the letter. She has written that she received her uncle's letter the day before, and along with it was the gift parcel that he had sent to her for her birthday. And here is a line, I jumped for joy when I opened the parcel. Do you recall, children, I told you that you can use idioms while writing a personal letter. So jumped for joy is an example of an idiom. Idiom, I told you, is a phrase that enhances our language. So jumped for joy is an idiom which means I was extremely happy, I was very happy, I was very delighted when I opened the parcel. The next time something very joyful happens to you, when you are very happy because of some incident, you can express your happiness with this idiom. You can say, I jumped for joy when I got my result, or I jumped for joy when I got the first prize in the dance competition. So you may use this idiom now because you know the meaning of this idiom. Further, Tejaswini has written in the second paragraph, I got many gifts from my friends, but yours is the best of all. Thank you for gifting me the latest Harry Potter book. You know that I love reading and I wanted to read this book. You are the best uncle in the whole world. Just observe how full of love and affection this paragraph is. Tejaswini has expressed her gratitude and delight so beautifully. She has called her uncle best in the world and his gift the best among all the gifts that she got on her birthday. This explains the personal tone that we discussed in the key points. One more thing, children, the question we had specified the gift, that is a book. So, in the second para, I have named the book. You may write the name of any book that you desire to mention other than Harry Potter. Moreover, sometimes the object of the gift is not alluded to in the question. That means it is not written what the gift was. In such cases, we are free to write about any gift, like a watch, bicycle, football, a new dress, and so on. Along with the gift that you choose, you have to give the reason why you loved that gift so much. Just like Tejaswini, she has mentioned that since she is fond of reading and was herself planning to buy that book, similarly, you need to write why that particular gift is so special and valuable for you. This will make your letter sound more natural and genuine. In the conclusion, Tejaswini has once again thanked her uncle and she has asked him to convey her regards to her aunt and love to her cousin Muskan. Your loving niece is the complimentary closing that Tejaswini has chosen. If it would have been a boy, in place of niece, we would have written nephew. NEPHEW, nephew. The second question is, recently your exams were conducted. Write a letter to your father telling him how you have fared in your examination. You are Disha or Dhruv of hostel number 1, St. Kabir Public School, Bhopal. So children, you remember I told you that if you have to assume that you are living in a hostel, then you may be asked to write a letter to your parents as well. So here is an example of it. You have to assume yourself as Disha or Dhruv and you have to write to your father telling him about how you have fared. That means performed in your examination. In the question, we were provided with the sender's address. So we'll write the same here as I have done. Hostel number 1, St. Kabir Public School, Bhopal. Then the date, 19th May 2020. Here, the date is written before the month, so it is an ordinal number. The salutation that we have chosen this time is Dear Papa. It could have been Dear Father or Dearest Father or Dearest Papa. Your wish. Hope you are well with Mummy and Nisha. In my previous letter, I wrote to you about my preparation for the exams. I am pleased to inform you that my exams got over today. So here you can see that in the first paragraph, Disha has expressed the hope for the well-being of her family. And she has mentioned that she had earlier written to her father about the preparation of her exams. And now she is informing him that her exams are finally over. Further, in the second paragraph, Disha has written, the question papers were a bit difficult. However, I have cross-checked them with my teachers. They say that I have done all the papers quite well. So, I hope to secure good marks. I also look forward to returning home soon. So, here Disha has told her father how her papers went well, how she is very positive about getting good marks in the examination. Once again, let's go through the last line of the second paragraph. I also look forward to returning home soon. Here, look forward to is a phrase which means that I am waiting very happily to return home soon. So, this here means that Disha is anticipating her return to her home because she is living in a hostel, she misses her family, and after examination when she will have vacation, so she wants to reach home as soon as possible and she is very happy about it. She is very excited about going back home. So she has written this here. In the end, Disha has written, please convey my regards to mummy and love to Nisha. So very simple closing. She has just asked her father to convey regards to her mother and love to her sister, her sibling Nisha. Then yours affectionately, Disha. Complimentary close here is yours affectionately. You could have written your loving daughter Disha. Okay, that would also have been fine. So you can write any complimentary close that you wish to write. Moving on to our third and last example for today. You are Harsh. Write a letter to your friend in about 120 to 150 words describing your boarding school. So this is a letter to a friend, okay? And what you have to do is you have to describe your boarding school in this letter. That means you have to assume that you have recently been admitted or enrolled in a boarding school, and you have to tell your friend in the letter whether you like the school or not, how are your new teachers, your new classmates, and other things that you wish to tell him or her about your school. Now, since it is a boarding school, that means you are living at the campus of the school. You are living in the premises of the school in a hostel. So you have to write the address of the school in the sender's address. St. Thomas School, Jabalpur. Then comes the date, May 18, 2020. And the salutation, Dear Ritik. Now you are writing to your friend, so you will directly address your friend with his first name, Dear Ritik. Some children have this habit of writing the complete name of their friends in the letters along with the surname. Like some children would write Dear Ritik Sahu. So that is not appropriate. You don't every time address your friend with his full name. We usually call our friends by their first name. That seems more natural. So please take care about that. Write only the first name of your friend with dear or dearest. How have you been? I hope my letter finds you in the pink of health. I am writing to tell you about my new school. Now here an idiom has been used. The idiom is in the pink of health. In the pink of health means in very good health. So you may use this idiom in your informal letters. Along with idioms, we had studied in the key points that we can also use abbreviations while writing an informal letter. And here I have written some contractions in this letter. I'll explain to you as we come across them. The first one is in the third line of the first paragraph. It is I am. Contraction is a word or a phrase that has been shortened by dropping one or more letters, and in place of those dropped or missing letters we put an apostrophe. So here I apostrophe M is a contraction because it represents two words, I and am, am, I am. So instead of I am, I have written I am together, writing to tell you about my new school. It's been almost a month and I am very happy in my new school. The classes and dormitories are very spacious. There are well-equipped science labs and a library with a great collection of books. The school has amazing sports facilities such as swimming pool, horse riding track and a very large playground. The teachers are also very nice. So here in the beginning of the second paragraph also there's a contraction. The contraction is its. Its here stands for it has. So in place of it has been almost a month, I've contracted it and written it's been a month. Okay. So Harsh got enrolled in the boarding school a month back and now after a month he's writing to Ritik to tell him about his new boarding school. Harsh likes his school very much. He's very happy and comfortable there. He has described about the school building. He has told Ritik that there are spacious, very large classes and dormitories there. What is a dormitory? A dormitory is a very large hall where the students sleep at one place. There are a lot of beds there according to the number of students and the students sleep in that large hall called a dormitory. And there are very well equipped laboratories there, a nice library and the sports facility in the school are also very nice. And he has also praised the teachers of his new school. So the second paragraph, as you can see, contains the description of the boarding school as was asked or demanded in the question. Although I have made many new friends, I still miss you and the other friends. Please write to me about yourself. I'll wait for your letter. Pay my regards to your parents. In the third paragraph, Harsh has concluded by telling Ritik that he still misses his friends. He still misses Ritik in spite of having made new friends in the boarding school. And he has also asked Ritik to write a letter to him. And he has conveyed his regards or his respect to Ritik's parents. Then he has signed off as your friend, Harsh. And with the end of this letter, children, we come towards the end of today's class. And I really hope that you all learned something new today and enjoyed today's class. Before leaving, let us revise the key points that we need to consider to write a good informal letter. In front of you on the screen, you can see those key points. Just give a quick glance at them, please. Not only the key points, but the format is equally important. So, please go through the format also once again. Students, I have compiled a few practice questions for you to solve. The first question is, you are Shrejal or Sanjay of Shanti Nagar, Nagpur. Write a letter to your grandfather thanking him for the bicycle that he gifted to you on your birthday. So this question is very similar to the first question that we did in today's class. There have been only some modifications, some changes. In place of uncle, you have to write the letter to your grandfather this time. And the gift has been changed from book to a bicycle. So you can refer to the first letter of today's class to write this letter. And this letter, of course, is an informal letter because it is to be addressed to your grandfather. So in this letter, in place of writing about the book, you have to write about the bicycle. You can write in the second paragraph that now you won't have to walk to school. You can go on that bicycle to school and you can even enjoy cycling with your friends in the evening. So you may use such ideas. The last question is an informal letter, as you have to write a letter to your friend inviting him or her to spend summer break with you. So here either you can invite your friend to your own place, that is your own house, and tell him or her about the various fun activities that you have thought of or planned for both of you during the vacation, which may include a tour of your city. Or you can even write that you have planned to spend the vacation at a hill station with your friend, away from your own home. So it's completely up to you, whatever you may wish to write. You can write in this letter. We all know that practice makes a man perfect. So children, Please do practice writing these questions so that you can assess how much you have learned, how much you have understood. So that is all for today, and I take your leave now. Thank you, children.